Sweden has finally joined NATO. The obstacles facing Sweden's NATO membership from Hungary and Turkey have been cleared. With these two countries giving their approval, no more hurdles stand in Sweden's way. Sweden is now officially a NATO member, marking the end of its neutral stance. For around 200 years, Sweden abstained from taking sides in wars and remained reluctant to join any military alliance, aiming for peace and focusing on growth. Sweden refrained from involvement in the struggles of other countries, fostering an environment conducive to economic and social development within the nation. Even during the Cold War, Sweden neither joined the US-led NATO nor the Soviet-led Warsaw Pact. After the Cold War, Sweden further reduced its defense spending and focused its military on peacekeeping operations. For a long time, Sweden enjoyed progress due to a peaceful environment and maintained distance from NATO to avoid unnecessarily provoking Russia. In 2014, Russia annexed the Crimean Peninsula, which set off alarms in Sweden. As a result, Sweden began investing more in its military and started leaning towards NATO. Fast forward to 2022, when Russia invaded Ukraine. Concerned about its security, Sweden decided to abandon its policy of neutrality. It made the decision to join NATO to benefit from collective security under NATO's Article 5. According to Article 5, an attack on a NATO member will be considered an attack on all NATO members, binding them to collectively defend the attacked member. This acts as a deterrent and protects NATO members from potential attacks. It is this guarantee of collective security that led Sweden to officially join the US-led Western Military Alliance. If you recall, last year Finland became the 31st member of NATO. Now, Sweden has become the 32nd member of NATO. What began in 1949 with 12 founding members has now expanded into a military alliance of 32 nations. Russian President Vladimir Putin cited NATO's expansion as the reason behind his decision to invade Ukraine. With NATO continually expanding, it has reached the doorstep of Russia. Russia perceives this expansion as a threat to its national security. According to Putin, since he did not receive assurance that Ukraine would not join NATO, he felt compelled to invade Ukraine. Vladimir Putin aims to keep Ukraine under his sphere of influence. Look, the expansion of NATO threatened Russia and compelled it to respond. NATO, in return, used Russia's response as an excuse to expand further. Thus, NATO expands due to Russia's aggression, while Russia's aggression is fueled by NATO's expansion. What's next? Looking ahead, Sweden's addition will further increase NATO's dominance in the Baltic Sea region. Look at this map. Here, NATO members are highlighted in blue. Focus on Europe. This water body is the Baltic Sea. As you can see, it is surrounded by NATO members. This is Finland. It joined NATO in 2023, leaving Sweden as the last country in the region to join. Now, with Sweden becoming a NATO member in 2024, the entire Baltic Sea region is under NATO's influence. Here is a labeled map to provide a clearer picture. As you can see, all the countries surrounding the Baltic Sea are now members of NATO, except for the small territory which belongs to Russia. This is Russia's Kaliningrad exclave. If you want to learn more about Kaliningrad, there is a video on the channel. You can check it out by clicking on the I button in the top right corner. After watching the video, you will understand why Kaliningrad is important for Russia. Russia's Baltic Fleet is stationed here. Russia's northern ports freeze during winters and are not operational throughout the year. Unlike them, the Baltic Sea ports remain ice-free and operational year-round. Access to these warm water ports is crucial for Russia. A blockade in the Baltic Sea would significantly impact Russia's shipping and trade activities. With NATO's considerable presence and influence in the Baltic Sea, and now with Sweden joining the alliance, NATO has almost complete control over the shipping lanes in the region. NATO enjoys overwhelming air and naval superiority in the area, putting it in a clearly advantageous position. This makes it difficult for Russia to exert its control in the Baltic region. After joining NATO, Sweden will be required to increase its defense spending, which will divert money from its public services and social programs. Additionally, Sweden's decision to join NATO has strained its relations with Russia. Obviously, Russia perceives it as a provocation. Western countries are nervous because their harsh economic sanctions have not succeeded in crippling Russia's economy. In fact, Russia seems to have overcome them. In the war with Ukraine, Russia appears to be winning on the ground, frustrating Western countries. Any miscalculation due to the nervousness or frustration, such as threatening the free movement of Russian ships in the region, could lead to increased tensions and potentially escalate into a full-blown war between NATO and Russia. Thankfully, for now, such a possibility is low. However, over time, we will learn the long-term consequences of Sweden joining NATO.